me I sighed. I agree, and I'm sure my fellow adherents will agree. We leave Taupaki School stocked full of enough fuel to keep us warm for quite a while. My first day at school was 13th of June, 2011, a Monday. Always a good day to start somewhere new. After 8 years, and in my case, 7 teachers, it seems hard to remember we were once fresh-faced new entrants in 2010 and 2011. I guess we all remember what it's like being a new kid, not knowing anyone our age, unaware of where we should be or what we should be doing. This is something we will have to go through again in about 6 weeks' time at our new high schools. But apart from being older, there will be two crucial differences. First, Taupaki School and our teachers have equipped us to meet and overcome challenges. And second, we will hopefully have a few great friends with us, or at the end of a telephone to talk things through. We have been taught to face life challenges through many of our non-core learning adventures. I can think of at least 5 things we have learned. There is no problem that hasn't already been solved by someone else, usually with worse tools and fewer resources. The first field trip I remember as a new entrant was to Highland House, somewhere we could learn to wash clothes, repair things, and make butter. Possibly my parents were hoping that by the end of the day, I would have learned to be independent. Although this is true organizing the trip, and I guess you knew that it was all olden days equipment. I mean, who knew that making butter could be such hard work? It pays to think ahead carefully when doing something new. To get to modern cooking tools, we had to wait until year 4 when our class did some food. Unfortunately, I accidentally put metal in the microwave, and it was almost too late when I realized. Just before it exploded, I heard some popping. At first, I thought this must have been something else. Then I started to smell the burn. I tried not to make a big deal about it, but I think that some other people might have noticed the smell as well. The boundaries of our comfort zones need to be pushed against. In year 6, we went to cabin dinner. We had a great cabin spirit, walking around wearing yellow bandanas. Terrified, we walked across logs several meters from the ground. In the confidence course, we went under and over pieces of wood, under and over ropes, and by the end of it, we were covered in mud and monkey water. Not everything is as easy as it looks, and it also needs perseverance. In year 7, we went to Taupaki Camp. From Auckland, Randy Toto doesn't look too bad. By the time we got there, it had grown a lot. I found it hard work and learned a good lesson in perseverance. A lesson I also learned more about 2 weeks ago, crossing from the river. At Moto Tavern, I found that sailing appears graceful and fun, but it's actually way harder than it looks. We tried to catch the wind, but just ended up capsizing into the freezing cold water. While not everything is as easy as it looks, perseverance can help overcome and master it. You only learn humility by making a few face plants. The 2018 ski trip was a good time to learn this as a novice skier. On one run down Happy Valley, I couldn't quite remember how to do the pizza and stop. Then, all I could see was a group of people trying to back away as I came closer and closer. They couldn't avoid me, and I couldn't avoid my ungainly face plant. A little later, I was asked by some young guy on a ski lift if I'd known the person who fell under at the bottom of the hill. I had to admit I knew that person very well, even better than I'd known him a few years earlier. My years here at Taupaki School have been an amazing journey, and I would like to finish by thanking my 7 teachers. Unfortunately, 5 of them are no longer here at Taupaki School, but there is a nice symmetry tonight because my first teacher, Mrs. True, and my last teacher, Mrs. Booth, are both here. If my memories here at Taupaki School were imagined like a bookshelf, you guys would be the really cool and important solid bookends of my time, and I thank you. In between would be the super big books of learning and fun of my other fantastic teachers. And then then there would be the happy books